Hey guys, it's Chasey Poo again with other videos for you. Today I'm going to be talking to you about the effects of tea. I had lots of people ask me questions about what are the effects of tea and they wanted me to make a video that maybe explains it. And I think I'm going to put this in my friends and family educational videos just because I think that a lot of people are really confused about what hormones do to an individual when they start taking them. And I think that as somebody who's been on hormones for almost 4 years, I've experienced things. Might as well explain it to you. So I'm going to tell you that the first little change that might occur in somebody is that their throat might start to become a little bit itchy a couple of days after their first shot. And this can be psychological or it can actually be happening. Obviously, some people want the changes to happen so quickly that they think of these changes. And obviously, it doesn't happen that quickly. But the throat itching thing has happened to so many people. I 100% think that it's real for 90% of people, and that's because your vocal cords are thickening up because your voice is going to be, you know, lower and dropping slowly and slowly. And you should be able to see or hear a hearable difference. I would say it depends for everybody, of course, but I like maybe 2-3 months to 6 months, maybe like the biggest change, and then your voice will decrease lower until that. And even after a year on tea, your voice can decrease even more. If you want to watch some of my older videos where I'm like 1 year on tea compared to like now almost 4 years on tea, my voice sounds the same, but it's a bit deeper now. So now, in no particular order, I'm just going to talk about some of the changes that are going to occur as well. The menstruation cycle will end at about It changes for everybody, of course. So it's about like 1 to 4 months for most people. Skin will become oily. Of course, this is probably dreaded by most people, but acne does come for a lot of people. It's not for everybody, and it does really supposedly only last for the first 6-7 months of being on hormones. But for some people, it can last longer. Example, for me, I started getting acne about 2 months on tea. It lasted until like 9 months on tea, and then I didn't really get it anymore. Now I just have like a couple pimples. But of course, for some people, acne can become a really big problem, and then they have to go on other products like Proactive and all of these other prescription ones, which are completely fine if you want to get rid of acne. Of course, body hair, facial hair is going to start growing. As you can see, I almost have like a full beard. Your hair on your arms, on your legs, I'm trying to show you my legs, your stomach hair, the chest area, back. You're just going to get hair everywhere that you didn't think was going to get hair. And sorry for friends and family watching this, but watch out for your butt. Sorry if you didn't want to hear about that one, but it's a real change that occurs on testosterone, and I feel that everybody needs to be informed, as this is like a scientific, I'm trying to take like a scientific approach about here, but like I'm really being social, so I should probably like calm down a little bit. Body fat redistributes for most people. It could take a couple of months, probably around 6 months. Your area is going to become more narrow here, and your figure like that where the hips area is kind of going to lessen. Obviously, if you have some really big hips, you can't just hope that testosterone is going to completely get rid of all of it. It doesn't for a lot of people, but a lot of people get that more narrow look. And if you want tips on how to have that very like narrow V-shaped muscular, there are some really great videos on YouTube on how to exercise. Talking about exercise and muscle, the energy level that you're going to have when you go on hormones increases. The red blood cell production increases a lot more, so you do have a lot more energy. A little example, I live like on a hill kind of. Before I was on testosterone, I would get up the hill, it's like a 5-minute walk, and I would like go on my bed for 25 minutes like exhausted. Now I can run up the hill. So you do get a lot more energy, which is really great, and your muscles do become bigger and denser. And denser is probably not the right word, but when you exercise, it's easier to get muscles is what I'm trying to say. Unfortunately, male pattern baldness or thinning of the hair or hair falling out happens to most people who are trans and are on hormones like testosterone. it's something that we just have to deal with. There are some products that you might be able to go on. Your hairline will recede to a more male pattern. As you can see, mine is like more square now. Mine was not square before, and that's okay. I mean, it's thinning a bit. I think if I let my hair grow really long, I would still be like thick, like how it used to be when I was pre-tea, but I mean, I'm okay with my hair right now. It kind of sucks that it is decreasing, but if it does decrease anymore, I'll probably end up going on something to keep that hair. something that not a lot of people talk about, but your body odor is going to change, and that can be a good thing. It's like, I'm gonna be very stereotypical right now, but you're gonna smell like a man. Like, you start sweating a lot more, so you do need to wear a lot more deodorant. I apply like 3 times a day. That's not for everybody. Obviously, I'm just giving you my experience, but I do sweat a lot more, and my smell is more like, smells like I've been at the gym when I haven't. Even though this is for family and friends, there are 2 things here that might be a little not safe for work, not safe for family. So I'm sorry, but I do want to explain it because there are some people who are going to be watching this video who actually want to know about the changes about the area down there. The pee smell changes, and that's something that not a lot of people talk about either. It's a different smell. I don't even know how to explain it. It's just more, it's stronger, let's put it that way. And your area is going to grow a little more, not the whole area, like boom, but your area. I'm just not gonna go into details because I know the family and friends. If you have more questions about that, I will answer them for you. Some misconceptions about being on T. I have just a little side note over here. If you've already gone through female puberty, you aren't gonna grow any taller. Your feet are not going to grow, your hands are not going to grow. Cartilage does expand, so my nose did change a little bit because of the cartilage in it. Your hands and your feet might expand a little more, and that's only because of the cartilage. It's not actually going to grow. So if you are short and you've already gone through female puberty, testosterone is not going to make you grow any taller. You can get some support for your feet that have like a wedge in your shoe so that you are taller, but unfortunately, it's not going to make you taller. Another really big misconception is that tea changes your personality. It doesn't change your personality at all. I am literally the exact same person that I was 5 years ago. The only difference is that I am so much more confident in who I am and how I present myself, that I'm able to project myself in the way that I've always wanted to. And so confidence has really given my personality a boost to become the better me that I was always supposed to be. So that's a really great thing. But my person, I'm still the same person. I'm still funny. You know, I still have the exact same relationship that I have with my dad, and you know, it's your emotions change, but not your personality. And your emotions only change in a way that, like, you might get more angry because hormones are in your body and you might not get used to it, and if it is too high of a dose, you do need to go on a lower one so that you're not so angry if you feel like you need to change that. Just because you're on hormones and, you know, you start to pass more as male in society, it doesn't mean that you're going to become some misogynistic a-hole, to use any other words that I can think of. It doesn't make you into a raging man who's going to start beating on people. Honestly, it made me more comfortable in who I am, and it made me really find out who I really am deep inside, because I was able to project myself, which was really great. And I think that that's a really big misconception, is that tea changes you. Tea doesn't change you. It changes you for a good way in your mind. I don't know how to explain it as better as that. And the one last misconception that I want to bring up is that tea does not change your sexual orientation. A lot of people think that when you're going on tea, you're going to change your sexual orientation. Okay, so for parents and friends who are watching this who might not understand, this is your friend. They are trans. They're white here. Or let's make them blue. Let's make them blue. This person is attracted to a woman. Okay, so in your eyes, before they came out, they were lesbians. Yes? Okay. So when your friend or your family member comes out, they're attracted to women, that means that they're straight. They're straight male looking for straight women. That's fine. But sometimes, even if that person that you knew was only attracted to women, being on T might make people some more comfortable with their sexuality and exploring things. They might go for men. So then they would be gay men searching for gay men. And that's completely fine. T doesn't change your sexual orientation, but I think that for a lot of people, people are able to express themselves a lot better and able to open themselves up and not close themselves off so much and maybe explore their sexuality a little more. So why not explore it? You know, we're young, why not? So that's really it that I have. If you guys have any questions for me, please let me know and I will answer them as best as I can and make some videos for you. I hope you have a great week, and I hope this was informational. God, I almost messed it up. Love you.